I too was a participant in the Place of Her Own Residency, 2016. So this is the second piece I would count. I had a woodblock print up in college in like way back. But other than that, this is like the second piece of art that I've actually put up and has been shown and presented for other viewers. Just want to say that this piece, and in contrast to the piece that I created for Place, came up like that. There was just something that triggered me to want to work with this theme thematically. It was just so full and charged. There's an incident that happened to me just recently that kind of rocked me to the core, shook me to a place of just, I don't know how to describe it, fear and panic and an uncertainty about my sense of place and home. It's kind of a little domestic quarrel in my living situation that made me look at what this fear that shook me to my core was about. And I had to just step back and look at it. So Cynthia offered to be part of this show. Thank you so much, Cynthia. And I took it on. I saw this as an opportunity to really explore some really deep-seated issues that I probably haven't been able to address until now in my life. So thematically, I'm working with ancestral trauma and how violence has played a significant role in my lineage, in my family, in their families, and all the generations previous to me, and how that has been just deeply embedded in ourselves. I come from a culture that has been colonized for hundreds of years, from being the Philippines, which is my heritage, I'm a Filipino heritage, has been visited and, just many, many people have come through. I don't know, I don't have any time for a history lesson right now, but I'm Russian, French, English, Dutch, Portuguese, Spain, and America. So I'm working with maybe like on a historical context, like old colonial colonization and the effects of colonialism. Then also how that has been passed down just in generations down the line to where it is intrinsically a part of the domestic like realm. It's household tradition to like smack a kid and not, you know, maybe it's not just my culture, it's probably shared among many cultures. So I decided to work with that thematically. And what has that done to me as a person, to us as a human race, when violence is like one of the main ways of communicating? In a sense, it's maybe concern and deep love. Somewhere deep down there's some sense of care. So violence has been part of the household tradition. This piece. So I've studied different. I've worked with different media, painting, drawing, what have you. But I really have been drawn to found objects and assemblage. And with the exception of maybe making a plaster of Paris heart, which is my heart that's wounded and is open to being healed, I pretty much found things. The little nightstand has been in my family. I don't know who had it before me, but I've always remembered it since my childhood to have it in my room somewhere with like little books, and it's always been my family. And when I started to put this together, it was like, oh, wounded heart, and I had these glass discs that I was gonna use as teardrops, and it's like, oh, concept, it's getting really conceptual. conceptual, but I started pulling things together that started to mean something related to my family, and I started to see how I put together this tier. And it wasn't intentional, but the way I'm breaking it down now, it's like generationally, I think historically the crate on the bottom that's been covered with muslin and wrapped with cords 7 times, representing the 7 generations that, you know, before, you know, maybe say things can break through, heal, it's from maybe a tradition of borrowing from, you know, peoples, but I believe that like after a certain number of generations, we just start to open up and heal, and I think I'm stepping into that place. Ancestors, and then my dad, who was about 9, 10 years older than my mom, is on the bottom shelf because he's older, and then mom on the next shelf and me on the top. These are all household items I found that have been in storage and I pulled out, and they're basically utilitarian objects, but they have, just by the nature of our minds and how we create stories, they could have many, many uses and meanings behind them. So I think it's a healing, it's a piece about ultimately healing and letting light enter your heart. The quote was found in a writing workshop I attended, held by a friend of mine, Delina Patrice Brooks, does wonderful work in Oakland. She's a performer, director, actor, dancer. And this quote, this Rumi quote, was up on the wall on big pieces of butcher paper. And that I kind of flew a riff on that, the Rumi quote.
Quotes on your teardrops?
Yeah. I forgive myself. Don't tell anyone. I didn't mean to hurt you. It was for your own good. It didn't really hurt, did it? I didn't mean it. I only do it because I love you. I'm sorry. It wasn't my fault. I forgive. I'll never do it again. I forgive you. Forgive me. I am safe. I belong to myself. I am loved. I am cared for. My body is sacred. I am okay.